So hey everyone, this is how to use S Shake to make an X Shake on Premiere Pro. So to begin, prepare your clip. And then what we want to do is find S Shake, so it should be underneath Sapphire Distort, add it onto your clip. So because it's an X Shake, we want it to be horizontal only, so no vertical, no tilt, no Z Shake either. At the moment, you can see it's kind of randomized. We want it to look smooth. So what we're gonna do is open up the X Shake and decrease this, so the rand amp to 0. And you want to do this for the Y as well. And then what you want to do, so we're just focusing on the X shake, not the Y, so you can close that. What you want to do is increase the wave amp, not the rand amp. So increase this to around, let's go for 200 and see how that looks. So scroll back up, and what you want to do is make sure that your playhead is at the very start of your clip and keyframe the amplitude. So hit that stopwatch, and that's going to set a keyframe. Head towards the end of your clip, so not literally to the end, but somewhere around here. It does not have to be specific. So for me, it's about 20 frames in, and you want to set the amplitude all the way down to 0. And what we're going to do is graph this. In fact, before we do that, check this motion blur box here, which will add blur onto your shake. And let's see how it looks so far. Okay, not too bad at all. You've probably already noticed that there are actually a few issues. For example, you can see this reflection. It's very obvious. So what we're going to do is hide it by increasing the motion blur length. So let me try something like 4. Now it's got a lot more motion blur. So let me play it back. It can definitely look better, and we can do this by right clicking on our second keyframe for the amplitude and selecting ease in. And now if I play it back, you can see it looks much smoother than before. However, we can go even further by opening up the graphs. So if you click on this arrow next to the stopwatch, that's going to bring down the graph. And what you can do is grab the handle for this second keyframe. So grab this and put it all the way to the left, but you want to make sure that it's leveled, which means it can't be too high or too low. Leveled, meaning around here. So it should look like a very smooth curve. And there you go. You now have a perfect X shake effect on Premiere Pro. If you want similar shakes just like this, then grab my free S shake pack in the description below. Make sure to check out this tutorial if you're interested. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.